how to create infinite text motion backgrounds in DaVinci Resolve, which looks something like this. Let's get started. First, let's bring in the text. Go to the Effects tab on the top left of your screen, go to Titles and bring in Text Plus. Once we have the text, go to Inspector tab and type in whatever you want. I'm going to type in Infinite. Then I'll change the font to Rubik, change its weight to extra bold, and then you can change the color size and it goes on. Once the text is ready, go to the Fusion page. Here, this template, that's our text. First thing that we're going to do is apply a transform node to it. How to do it? Click on template, go to effects tab, go to open effects, search for transform, and then double click on this one. The transform node's here. Next step, click on it, go to the inspector tab, and here we have all these settings. First thing, go to advanced options and change the edge behavior from transparent to wrap around. What it does is, it will take your object, that's our text, and apply it around our text, which is at the top, bottom, right, and left. But we have already selected wraparound, right? Why isn't it here? That's because there's empty space around this text, right? We need to crop it out. How to do that? Go to Image Adjustment, select Crop and Crop, and we've got all these options. First, let's start cropping the left side, which is this part of it. Let's crop it. Now, as I go on and on, as you can see, there's some text coming in, but that text itself is also getting cropped, right? We don't want that. So what we are going to do is, we're going to crop it only this much. Now, still there's no text visible, right? Why? Because the right side needs to be cropped. Now, this blank space that's left, that's the right side of the text that's out here. And this right side, this blank space is of this text. So let's crop right. And as you can see, we've got text from all around, from left and right. Same thing, we're going to go for top and bottom. Let's start cropping the top, just till here, and then bottom, and we've got text from top and bottom as well. Now, it totally depends on you how much gap you want to keep between the text, but I'm gonna go with this much. Next step, you can also zoom out. So go to position controls and zoom out, and we've got a lot of text. Yeah, so it totally depends on your preferences. I'm gonna go with this much size. Now, if I go to the edit page, as you can see, we've got a lot of text, but it's not moving. We can also apply motion to it. So go back to the Fusion page and here, go to position X. We go to the first frame and apply a keyframe. Let's keep it 0 only. Then we'll go to the last frame, which is here. Then again apply a keyframe and then we'll move it from right to left. This much. Alright, you can move it from right to left, left to right, top to bottom. For top and bottom, you have to go with position Y. But that totally depends upon your preferences. I'm going to go with right to left. So we've applied the two keyframes. Now, if I play it, as you can see, the text is flowing. If you want a slower motion, just go to the second keyframe and you can move that keyframe like this. So it goes slower now. So now if I go to the edit page, the text is moving. Let's pause it. Now, let's say my timeline has grown. Okay, my timeline goes till this much. But now, if I extend this little text element and if I play it, as you can see, it's moving, but then it stops. Why? Because the second keyframe was somewhere around here, right? But after that, there's nothing. So if you want this text to move for an infinite amount of time, what we're going to do is just click on it, go to the Fusion page. Here, select the transform node and go to spline. As you can see, transform one, which is the name of our node, just select it. And we have applied keyframes to position X, right? So now, let's go back here, somewhere around here, and as you can see, there's two keyframes. I'll decrease the size of it, squeeze it up, and as you can see, there's two keyframes, the keyframe, the first one, and then the second one, which was here, right? So what we're gonna do is, select both of these keyframes. As you can see, it goes flat around here, right? So select both of the keyframes, and then click on this little button right here, which says Set Relative. Once you click on it, as you can see, the flat line just changed. So now, if I scroll below, and as you can see, it's going on for an infinite number of times. So now, if we go back to the edit page, and if we play the clip, as you can see, it's going on and on and on. Even if I extend it to as much time as I want, like this, it will still go on and on and on. So that's how you can create infinite text motion background in DaVinci Resolve. That's it for the video, guys. I hope you find this video useful, and if you do, make sure you like the video. It really helps the algorithm suggest this video to the needful people. Also, share this video with your friends and consider subscribing to the channel. I post such DaVinci Resolve tutorials, how to tech videos, tech reviews. I stream games on the channel occasionally, and I post some knowledgeable and informative YouTube shorts. And that brings us to the end of the video, guys. Thank you for watching the video. I'll see you all next time. Bye-bye.